This tutorial is an introduction to network modeling. We're going to talk about a special type of linear program whose structure provides some very nice capabilities from a modeling standpoint and also from a solution standpoint. So we're going to talk first briefly about the value of network models and different categories of networks. There are a couple of types that we're going to look at. The simplest one is what we call pure network flow problems. Then we'll look at generalized networks and then networks with special side constraints. We'll focus first on the pure network problems. And the reason we studied these separately from just a standard linear programming model is that they really are in many ways the most widely used optimization models in practice because they present a natural way to represent and model problems. There is a pictorial form that accompanies the model so that you don't have to actually show the user or end user a mathematical formulation. The pictorial form will essentially do the same thing, but without the equations and the algebraic notation of decision variables and so on. In some cases, the solutions that we get are automatically integer valued so that we do not have to invest in a time-consuming solution method to solve these problems. In fact, they are, by being a linear program, we can solve them quickly, and the fact that they have a special structure has led to the development of extremely fast solution algorithms and software so that you can attack large-scale problems in the orders of millions, tens of millions of problems, solve those rather quickly. So by the natural problem representation, I mean that most linear programming problems have a substantial network component, and the application areas that you can find descriptions of in the literature include just the routing of aircraft, planning of personnel, plant location problems, project management models, missile targeting, and a number of other ones here that you see listed on the screen. And some of these we'll look at as we go through the class today. Now, this is a pictorial form of a simple network. It's not complete, but this gives you the general idea of what we mean as a graphical format of the network. So it enhances not only your modeling process itself, but also communicating the model to others so that they'll be more likely to be accepted by the end user, and they can even participate in the modeling at some point. So it's easy to relate to and understand. So for example, in this model we have shown on the left side a series of circles, which we call nodes, and we have on the right a series of additional nodes. The circles on this side form some other nodes, and so each one of these circles you could think of here obviously represents a city, and the arrows connecting those city pairs represent a movement or a weight in which movement can happen between certain pairs of cities. And so these pure networks we'll look at first are simply linear programs that have integer valued solutions when the problem data is integer valued. So we can avoid those integer programming formulations that can be difficult to solve. And so we can model people hired, planes scheduled, ships built, deliveries made, boxcars used, and so on. As long as using this format, if we are careful and keep the formulation and capture enough of the problem, the real problem at hand, within the network format. In addition to these characteristics, just the nature of the linear program structure allows specialized algorithms to be developed that can solve network models a couple orders of magnitude faster than a general linear program. And also, these software, these codes, many of which people in this department, including myself, have worked on, are not only fast, but they use very little memory in terms of the in-memory RAM requirements. So you can solve large-scale problems quite quickly. So here's these times are probably a bit old now, but here's a network with 10,000 constraints and 80,000 variables. That's less than a second, 250,000 constraints. Each of those would be a node, of course, and 2 million variables in 30 seconds on a decent PC. This would probably be, much faster now. So the fact that you can solve them and it doesn't take up much memory, solve them quickly, it makes it nice for interactive applications. Also for large-scale problems as well. So there was a recent example from running a microdata merge problem, which is now sometimes called data fusion, where we're matching records from two large data files in such a way as we can combine these survey files into a single composite file based on overlapping information, but not where you have unique people being matched up. You're matching up records based on common characteristics. This is something I worked on with the U.S. Treasury Department a number of years ago. But in running some models from this, they're transportation problems. So here was like 4 million variables in 9 seconds. And as it got larger, it took up to a half an hour to solve a really significant large-scale problem. And this is a result of some research I did with Fred Glover and my advisor, Darwin Klingman. We've all worked in the area of network algorithms for a good number of years. Okay, so that was we're going to talk about this particular merge example later in the semester. But there are other applications we'll talk about also in the context of this section of the class. Personnel assignment models, manpower planning, logistics and distribution. You can see the list here. Telecom network design. All of these are important problems that can be take advantage of the speed and the interactive nature of this type of optimization problem. So if you can get your problem into this format, you can take advantage of this technology.